Guten Abend. Guten Abend, meine Damen und Herren. Mein Name ist Erik Petzoldt. Ich heiße Sie herzlich willkommen hier im DOC 4 zu der Veranstaltung, durchgeführt vom Zentrum für interkulturelle Musik in Kassel, marokkanische Musik und Jazz. Ich bin sehr, sehr froh, dass wir diese Veranstaltung jetzt überhaupt durchführen können, gefühlt irgendwie kurz vor dem nächsten Lockdown. Diese Veranstaltung ist eigentlich 2 Jahre lang geplant worden. Ich mache in Cambridge meinen Doktor über Jazz in Marokko und im Zuge dessen habe ich 2019 Jauk Armand Elmaleh-Lemal kennengelernt. Den habe ich auch besucht, habe mit ihm in seinem Haus in der Nähe von Casablanca gewohnt, viele Interviews gemacht und viel Musik gemacht. Und über sein Leben, über sein Werk werden Sie gleich viel hören. Ich möchte einmal Dank aussprechen, einmal an die Förderer des Interkulturellen Zentrums für Musik in Kassel, aber auch an Marco Krummenacher und das Kulturhaus DOC 4. Und wir haben parallel auch einen Livestream von diesem Event, also es wird ein Vortrag sein und eben ein Konzert. Der Livestream wird gerade gesendet über die Forschergruppe, wo ich in Cambridge aktiv bin. Past and Present Musical Encounters Across the Strait of Gibraltar heißt die. Da können Sie gerne auch im Internet mehr erfahren. Unter musicalencounters.co.uk. Und jetzt würde ich sagen, fangen wir mit dem Vortrag an von Rita Stirn-Wagner. Sie ist eine Schriftstellerin und auch eine Englischprofessorin. Sie hat das Buch Musicienne du Maroc, Morocco's Woman in Music, veröffentlicht, geschrieben. Ist in 3 Sprachen, Arabisch, Französisch und Englisch. Sie hat auch ein paar Exemplare mitgebracht, können Sie gerne auch erwerben oder einfach später oder in der Pause reingucken. Und ja, jetzt Rita, du kannst auf die Bühne kommen und wir freuen uns, deinen Vortrag zu hören. Jauk, a Moroccan French Jazz Musician and his Philosophy of Rhythm. Er wird in Englisch sein. Viel Spaß.
Danke. Vielen Dank für die Einladung hier in Kassel und ich bin wirklich sehr froh, in diesem Event teilzunehmen, an diesem Event teilzunehmen. So fängt mein Vortrag an, auf Englisch wie geplant. So I would like to start with presenting Morocco as a land of musical diversity. From north to south, east to west, and whether in cities or in the countryside, every region has its specific traditional music, along with the influx of modern Moroccan and international music, played on the radio, on television, and during numerous yearly festivals. A major landmark in the Moroccan musical heritage is the Andalusian period, called El Andalus, which refers to the Muslim-ruled period of the Iberian Peninsula and southern France. It's considered a golden age in art and science, especially during the Caliphate of Cordoba, a city that became one of the leading economic and cultural centers throughout the Mediterranean, Europe, and the Muslim world. From Al-Andalus came major scientific achievements in trigonometry, astronomy, surgery, pharmacology, and agronomy, which led to exchanges between the Muslim and the Christian world. The Emirate of Granada was the last one, and it ended in 1492. With the fall of Granada and the beginning of the Spanish Christian Reconquista, with the expulsion of all the Sephardic Jews from Spain, a majority of them chose to live in Morocco, Algeria, and Tunisia. Also, between 1492 and 1610, 3 million Muslims left voluntarily or were expelled from Spain and resettled in North Africa. To this day, the golden age of the caliphates is being honored in the Arab world. At the same time, there is a vivid nostalgia for the Judeo-Arab culture that had prevailed in Al-Andalus. And this Judeo-Arab heritage is still celebrated in music by orchestra playing in Morocco, Algeria, and Tunisia. And here we have a slide with the kanun, a traditional instrument. For those who are interested, a yearly festival celebrates Andalusian music in Essaouira in March with a festival called Les Andalousies Atlantiques. Some of these orchestras are all women's orchestras, as in Tangier and Tetouan, and they keep alive a Judeo-Arab repertoire dating back to that golden age in Andalusia. And now I'm offering another extract called Blanca Nina with a vocalist, Samira Kadiri. Another pillar of Moroccan music is of Berber, Amazigh tradition, from northern and southern parts of the country and the Atlas Mountains. Traditional collective songs, such as the Aïta, which is a kind of blues or a cry of people's souls, as it's called, songs of tribes called the Issawa, the Ahidus, or Ahawash. And in these songs, dance and hand clapping are included in the performance. To finish the portrait of the variety, there is also the Saharan music, in which women play a drum called gedra, and they dance as well. I would like to move on to Gnawa music you might have heard about, with various instruments, this one called the Gembri. The second Gnawa instrument will be the krakab, sort of hand cymbals. And the third one is a drum called the bel. So music shared by these tribes is shared by both Berber and Arab communities. And the Gnawa musicians are organized as a spiritual brotherhood. They live off donations and play in the streets or at weddings, but also in ritual ceremonies called lila, which means night in Arabic. During a lila, some members in the audience might reach a state of trance And Gnawas have a reputation of being healers who can soothe the soul and spirit of people. They're famous for their dances, high jumps without run-up, and head rotations during their performances. They wear colorful clothes with little shells called kori as decorations of necklaces or belts. And originally the term Gnawa refers to Guinea, meaning black Africa, and the Arab slave trade across the Sahara. It is said that the cymbals you have just heard, called the krakab, played by the Gnawas, are a reminder of the noise of the chains at their feet during the slave trade. And now some musicians in the streets play Gnawa music. It's an Essaouira. I need to add here that Gnawa music became popular and internationally thanks to the American pianist Randy Weston, who played in Morocco and stayed in Morocco for 2 years to study Gnawa rhythm and music. He started a long musical partnership with a Gnawa master from Tangier and initiated a fusion between jazz and Gnawa in the 70s. It gave the impetus to the creation of the Essaouira Gnawa Festival, which now attracts an international audience. And Gnawa music is now part of the image of Morocco, and it's very popular also among the younger generation. It's cult music for Moroccan surfers, for instance. So currently there is a new generation of Gnawa musicians who play a fusion between Gnawa and blues or jazz while using traditional instruments. Female soloists on the gembri, usually played by men, have also appeared recently. And I would like to add that UNESCO included Gnawa music in the World Cultural Heritage in 2019. And now I would skip to the importance of languages and various music styles. The languages used in songs from our classical Arabic for poetical songs called malhoun, or spoken Arabic in popular music called shabi. But some lyrics are also in English or in French in modern music, as well as in rap and hip hop. And to illustrate this linguistic variety and also the international character of the singer who is accompanied by a Dutch female percussionist, a French trumpet player, a Cuban bassist, I really would like a focus on with the extract Wali. And she plays the crackle. Music is definitely a passion shared and lived by most Moroccans, and you may see a taxi driver drumming a rhythm on his dashboard or hear a colleague singing a traditional popular song of his region while using his desk as a drum, or hear a teenager sing a whole song while shopping. In general, a lot of rhythms are transmitted by women within the families during the family gatherings, religious rituals. They usually play a tambourine called bendir or a small drum called the tarija or davuka, and we have one here, you'll see it later, as well as the cymbals you've just seen, the krakab, as played by Thus, when Jauk, who is here with us tonight, got first exposed to jazz music, he felt the impact of his own background on his sense of rhythm and melody. And he sensed that jazz was an opening, was opening for him a free musical territory. Bearing this in mind, he entered the jazz scene in his early teenage years in Casablanca. So now I would like to focus on jazz in Morocco. How did jazz come to Morocco and eventually became Moroccan jazz? In the 30s, American jazz musicians felt attracted to Arab music, improvisation, and Oriental rhythms. The title Caravan was composed in 1936 by Juan Tizol and played by Duke Ellington. In 1944, Dizzy Gillespie created Night in Tunisia, and the same year, the composer Gil Evans produced a jazz arrangement of Arab dance by Mussorgsky. The Orientalist trend continued in 1959 with a piece called East Meets West, composed by Ahmed Abdul Malik of Sudanese origin. He was born in 1923 and died in 1993. He lived in New York City and was the bass player of Art Blakey, Thelonious Monk, and Randy Weston. But before that time, in 1958, he had played the Arab oud to record an album entitled Sahara Jazz. So for this, we will have an extract of Caravan. And it's also the period, I would like to highlight, the period of free jazz and black power with the Black Muslims. So during that period of what would be called Orientalism in the USA, there was a growing interest in Islam among the Afro-American community and its artists. Some of them joined the Black Muslims who were tracing their African roots and took Arab names. The pianist, named originally Fritz Jones, became Ahmad Jamal and was followed by a number of musicians who changed their original names and became part of that movement called Jazz and Black Power. And now we switch back to Morocco with Casablanca Jazz. So American soldiers had landed on the Moroccan coast during World War II, and the NATO forces settled afterwards in Casablanca, Rabat, and Kenitra, and participated in spreading jazz in Morocco with bands, bars, and jam sessions, and the circulation or sales of records. Jazz developed in Morocco in the 50s and the 60s, and Moroccan jazz bands started playing jazz standards in concerts and clubs, such as the Armstrong in Casablanca. And the film named Casablanca was released in 1947, and its soundtrack became well known among all the jazz fans in Morocco. And of course, the movie is well known in Europe too.
I'll hum it for you. Sing it, Sam.
You must remember this. A kiss is just a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you, on that you can rely.
Through the development of jazz in France, jazz music came to Morocco with the presence of French expatriates and Moroccan-born French settlers who've lived in major Moroccan cities. They were more interested in music coming from France than in local Moroccan music, apparently. This urban French population tended to be influenced by the jazz scene in Paris, and a jazz club called the Hot Club, a copy of the one in Paris, opened in Rabat in 1955.
Willis Conover is next with jazz.
Time for jazz. Willis Conover in Washington, D.C. with The Voice of America Jazz Hour.
So the International Free City of Tangier also offered an opening for jazz music through its radio channel called Radio Tangier International and Voice of America, the presence of the American legation and American expatriates favored this trend. And now we have a slide on the Beat Generation you might have heard about, which gave a mythical role to the city of Tangier. Among them, Paul Bowles, an American writer and pianist, and his wife Jane Bowles, a writer too, who had arrived in Tangier in 1947. They were joined by the members of the Beat Generation, Allen Ginsberg, for instance, and William Burroughs, who became famous writers. They were the pioneers of what was called later the hippie trend to Morocco in the 70s. During his stay in Morocco, where a land where he was buried, Paul Bowles explored Moroccan traditional music and went on field trips to record the music of tribes of the Rif Mountains and elsewhere. His impressive recordings of them, by their number, 16 CDs altogether, used to be in the National Archives in Washington, but they can now be found in the library of the American Legation in Tangier again. So during the 60s, famous black American jazz musicians such as Archie Shepp, Don Cherry, to name only two, toured North Africa. Jacques Mouyal, a radio speaker and saxophonist, opened a jazz club in Tangier called the African Rhythms Club with Randy Weston. Philippe Laurin, the founder and director of Tanjazz, the Tangier Jazz Festival, said, "Jacques Mouyal is a living legend of jazz in Morocco and the best specialist on the subject, but he no longer lives in Morocco." In July 1969, another important musical event and jazz event took place with the Pan-African Festival in Algiers, and it attracted a number of black American jazzmen to North Africa. Now, I would like to ask the question, how did jazz music actually become Moroccan jazz? In the 70s and 80s, there were successful radio and music programs called Jazz Rock, Jazz Times, launched by Saïd Fouad, who managed to interview top-notch jazz musicians such as Ornette Coleman, who came to Morocco in 1973. Young Moroccans felt excited about music coming from America, says Abdellah Winrir from Rabat. "I have a long history with jazz," he says. "It started when I was in high school, and we used to listen to Saïd Fouad's program from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. from Monday to Friday." Jazz was also played by big bands of the armed forces, and to this day, the Royal Symphony Orchestra gives jazz concerts in major Moroccan cities. The French and American cultural centers contributed to broadcasting jazz in Moroccan cities, and I can also add the Goethe Institute, of course. Georges Herkel, a French saxophonist living in Marrakech in 1985, played with John Shikai and the Moroccan jazz quartet of Toufik Ouldamar. In 1996, Pharaoh Sanders came to Morocco to record his Gnawa-influenced album, The Trance of Seven Colors, in reference to the color symbolism of Gnawa ritual ceremonies. And now we have a slide on Tanjaz. And I would like to pay tribute to Philippe Laurent, who founded the festival in 1999 in Tangier, named it Tanjaz, and he remained the director of the festival for 20 years, that's to say till 2019. In 2016, though, Philippe Laurent offered a pioneering all-female programming for the jazz festival to give more visibility to the women of the international jazz scene. So to give a feeling of the influence of jazz on the repertoire of the Royal Symphony, we have this extract here. And in Rabat, there is a jazz festival that had started in the Kasbah of the Udayas, and places it now takes place in the enchanting ruins of the Shella, which is a former Roman ruin in Rabat. The festival is financed by the European Union and is based on a musical partnership on stage between Moroccan and European musicians. It usually takes place in September and offers exposure to jazz and fusion music to a wide Moroccan and international audience. Rabat also has its jazz club called Le Pietri, thanks to its owner, Driss Ben Abdallah, who is a supporter of the Moroccan jazz scene and promotes many young musicians on his stage. Among them, the Frères Suissi. Yeah, maybe go to the next thing. I could also quote for the Moroccan aspect of jazz, female singers, well-known, Touria Hadraoui in Morocco, who sings traditional Sufi poetry and Melhoun. But she also toured in Denmark with the jazz guitarist, Corey van Binsbergen, and she toured France with the clarinetist, Louis Clavis. On the other hand, the singer you've met before, composes her songs with jazzy rhythms and is accompanied on stage by international jazz musicians, among other traditional musicians playing the oud. And other examples of jazz in Morocco are Otman Khaloufi and Majid Bekas playing with Louis Clavis, and who also give another vision of jazz, jazz beldi and gnawa jazz, as they call it. This is called Gnawa jazz because of the instrument, the gembri. And the rhythm and the singing. So concerning Majid Bekas, I would say he was originally a jazz guitarist. As a German music agent, and he appears in major international festivals. Now, something which has changed also the American jazz scene is the presence of migrants coming from Senegal, Ivory Coast, Cameroon, and Congo, for instance, among whom were former professional musicians. They contributed to the Moroccan jazz scene, and African bands, or mixed African-Moroccan bands, like Jauk's Afromed, I will talk about it later, participate in all the major festivals in Morocco. So Morocco has definitely adopted jazz music as a universal language, and it's well represented by the younger generation studying jazz in Moroccan conservatories, along with classical and traditional music. Traditional Moroccan instruments such as the oud, the violin, the flute, the kanun, or the gembri are now being used by soloists in jazz bands. International jazz musicians usually love to come and play in Morocco because the audiences are very reactive and always give them a very enthusiastic applause. Here are some of these instruments I've mentioned. Also often played by women. So Jauk will play the darbuka probably. So this is the instrument you saw with the Andalusian orchestra. So now I would like to focus on Jauk and his multiple identities after the flute. Here we are, Jauk and his multiple identities. So Jauk is of dual nationality, Moroccan and French, and has multiple and moving identities, as Amin Maalouf, the Lebanese writer, would call them, especially concerning his different names on both sides of the Mediterranean. Jauk was born in 1944 to Moroccan Jewish parents, Simon Elmaleh and Zahra Meshali, and was named Amran Elmaleh. He grew up in the Jewish neighborhood, the Mela of Casablanca. His parents separated when he was still a child, and his mother married a Frenchman, Papa Poissonnier, as Jauk affectionately calls him. And it allowed Jauk to have the French nationality under the name Armand Lemal. First band Armand Lemal played in, the Jaguars. At home, he spoke Moroccan Arabic called Darija and French, which was also the language of his schooling in Casablanca. Jauk does not have any knowledge of written Arabic or Hebrew, but has a Christian background in his upbringing. Humorously, Jauk says, or said in an interview related in the film by Michael Clouet, "I'm a Muslim on Friday, a Jew on Saturday, a Christian on Sunday, but basically I'm an atheist and an animist before that." After his military service, at the death of Papa Poissonnier, Jauk moved to France in 1967 and used his French identity papers on which Amran had become Armand and Elmaleh was Lemal. So Armand Lemal is the name under which Jauk has been known in France till today as a jazz musician, a lecturer in musicology in Paris at La Sorbonne and other institutions. But in the meantime, he had also been called Armand Elmaleh or Jauk Armand, a contraction of Armand and Lemal in the French media. When Armand Lemal left France in the late 90s, he returned to Morocco, to Casablanca, where he had inherited a farmhouse and property where he still lives today. And he took the name Jauk, which means gathering music bands, and Jauk is the name under which he conducted all his recent musical projects in Morocco. And it's also the name by which everybody calls him now, whether in Morocco, France, or Germany, or other places. One of his neighbors in Marseille, where Jauk is living when he's not in Casablanca, says, "Jauk is a Parisian in Paris, a Marseillais in Marseille, and a Kazawi in Casablanca. He is a chameleon." So now I would like to switch to Jauk's career and philosophy of rhythm. Jauk confessed that as a teenager, he experienced what is called a state of musical beatitude, a mystic revelation with the discovery of jazz and a decisive moment in his life in the making of Jauk the drummer. At the age of 16 and onwards, he turned into a prodigy and played the drums in a band called the Jaguars in Casablanca. They had bought their instruments from American soldiers who were leaving, said Jauk. The Jaguars became local celebrities and started touring Morocco, but also Spain, with concerts in Marbella from 1962 to 67, the year Jauk left Morocco and felt ready for a musical challenge in France at the age of 23. As a drummer, Jauk created his own musical identity and his language of rhythm, a rhythm called dakka, which is the traditional rhythm of the Ahouash Berber tribes. In that sense, Jauk was unique in the French jazz scene. Sorry, I have some water. And he elaborated his own philosophy of rhythm in jazz. He would always mix jazz with dakka rhythms, unknown to most French jazz musicians at the time. So the dakka rhythm became Jauk's trademark when he joined the Paris jazz scene.
They're very serious about their dancing. They've come from around the nation and from at least six foreign countries to be at the Catherine Dunham International Dance Seminar held here in SIU Edwardsville.
So this slide is about a very important meeting in 1989. While in Paris, he was given a sudden opportunity, 1969, he was given a sudden opportunity to play for an Afro-American dancer called Vanoye Aikens. Without any previous rehearsal, Jauk joined his performance and concentrated on the rhythm the American musicians were playing. At some point, he perceived they were playing his dakka, as he says. So he felt at ease and played his heart out. At the end of the performance, Vanoye Aikens told Jauk, "I've never heard a drummer play my African origins." And so a new career started for Jauk to accompany dancers, like in a high school, Chateaubriand. We just did that during the workshop. So there were no less than 750 students in that workshop. And a journalist attending the performance gave the following comment. Jauk managed to express rhythm through the eyes, the ears, the head, and body. And later he also taught at La Sorbonne, where he gave a course on dance studies.
Thank you.
So according to Jauk, there are three rhythmical phenomena: the heart, the step, and dance. A rhythm is perceived as ebb and flow. Between the ebb and the flow, there is a creative space, which binary rhythms do not provide. For Jauk, binary rhythms are like good and evil. There is no space in between. Whereas ternary rhythms, played in multiples, is what enhances creativity in Jauk's approach. Jauk also said that he had chosen the term dakka for his specific rhythm, just as there is a word for samba or batucada. It's easy to pronounce, and above all, it's a genuine Moroccan rhythm. So Jauk developed a reputation as a jazz percussionist in Paris, and his friend and fellow percussionist Mino Sinelu, you might know him, he played with Miles Davis, asked him to go to America with him. But Jauk refused, saying, "Why would I go to America to play jazz, which has its roots in Africa, where I come from?" So Jauk kept playing Dakka jazz and was recognized a jazz drummer by major jazzmen in France, such as Henri Texier, Daniel Humer, Bernard Lubat, as having an original and genuine style of drumming. Those musicians would come and ask him, "What's that stuff you're playing?" And Jauk says, "Well, it's the Dakka rhythm mixed with a jazz beat." So Jauk says, "I have Berberized French jazz." So now I will go to the discography and the famous tune called Dakka, which was on Jauk's record called Confluence, released in France in 1977. So there is another landmark in Jauk's career in 1983 with the opera Dakka at Le Printemps de Bourges, which is a talent discovering festival. And this was the time when Jauk was really considered as able to be representing world music along with Peter Gabriel in the same record shop and record rack. So this is the end of our encounter with Jauk. And for all of us, it has been a fatal encounter, especially for Pierre, who is here, the saxophone is playing tonight, for Eric, who has organized this event, who is the researcher on jazz in Morocco, and for me. And of course, all this will be illustrated by the concert tonight, because the mother of all this is the Mediterranean, says Jauk. The Mediterranean he calls Mama Titerani. And he will illustrate it by his piece called The Three Prophets. A statement meaning that Jesus, Moses, and Muhammad are all of the Mediterranean origin. And they also mean, of course, that Jauk belongs to a triple monotheistic culture. Thank you for listening to my presentation, and I wish you have a very good concert tonight. I'm sure you will. And as I said, I'm very honored to be here. Thank you.
Nochmal herzlich willkommen. Wir beginnen jetzt mit dem Konzert. Es ist mir eine große, große Freude, die Musiker anzukündigen. Wir haben einmal Aaron Seitz am Klavier. Sven Krug am Kontrabass. Ralf Wagner am Schlagzeug. Und dann aus Marseille Pierre Ballis am Altsaxophon. Und aus Marokko, aus Frankreich, Jauk Armand Elmaleh-Lemal.
Bonsoir. I don't speak English, I don't speak je l'ai dit en anglais. Little. Et bienvenue. I hope this concert sera, comment on peut dire, que ce sera bien.
Er hofft, dass das Konzert schön werden wird. Genau.
This group, il n'existe pas.
Genau. Diese Gruppe gab es nicht bis gestern.
Non, il n'existe pas. Là, c'est... Nous avons travaillé hier.
Yes.
Nous allons faire quelque chose aujourd'hui. Et tomorrow, fini.
Merci. Ok, viel Spaß.
Excuse me. Test, test, test. Ok. Alors, on va voir. Juste comme ça pour la tonalité, pour chauffer un peu. Mm-hmm. Ooh, yeah, habibti. please Eric, je voudrais annoncer que le premier morceau de Gnawa, c'est celui que nous allons jouer ici.
You want me to say that? This is disputed.
Yes, yes, it's very important, historic.
So this is one of the first pieces that Jauk has written, I believe.
Excuse me, I don't have le crack. Alors, ok, wow, tracatouf touf. Tracatouf-touf, 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 le jazz, without improvisation, no jazz, impossible. Ah. Yeah, yeah, c'est bon, on recommence. Alors, je vais rester calme. Hein. Tracatouf, touf, tracatouf, touf, tracatacata, papa, le papa, papa. Wow! Oh, Gnawi Mimoun, help me, Gnawi Mimoun, Sidi Bambara. Tracatouf, touf, tracatouf, touf, tracatacata, papa, papa, go! Thank you. Pom, 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 pom. Bam. Yeah. Oh Help me, ناوي هاك ناوي ميمون راه انا مدفون وي ناوي ميمون وي يا 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 وي اي جو با 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 C'est fini pour la violence. C'est le jazz. Nous sommes libres. C'est le jazz. On peut? Non, non-stop. We play. C'est un problème là. Excuse. Tiens, on a tout bougé. Ah, voilà, ça y est. Ouf. Ah. Nous improvisons.
Thank you.
jam performance. Thank you. Thank you, Sven. Thank you, Aaron. Let's go to the Dakka. Yes. My stick. Non, c'est pas celui-là. Attends. Tsunami. Yes.
Da 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 Thank you.
da 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 da. Ba 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 na ni na 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 na. S'il te plaît, tu expliques que nous allons jouer maintenant le premier morceau de jazz, Afromed, qui a 60 ans et qu'ils ont vu dans la conférence. Tu vas expliquer. Alors, qu'est-ce qui se passe? What happened? Voilà. À la maison, il y avait donc une mama amazigh marocaine. Yeah. Et sa petite fille, elle l'aidait dans le travail à la maison. Mais toujours elle faisait. Et my mother dit, yeah, ça suffit toujours, là, toujours. Every time, voilà. Alors vous allez entendre le petit the first jazz Afro-Med. Morocco, France, Europe. Voilà, il est là, Alors, c'est quoi le ton déjà? Mi bémol, je crois. Et elle, elle faisait. Voilà, il est là, C'est tout. Ah bon, ok. Et nous, nous avons. Alors, comment on rentre? One more time. Ba 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 ba. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh my God.
Vielen, vielen Dank. Jauk Armand Elmaleh-Lemal. Hey. Am Schlagzeug, am Gesang, am Gong. Mit der Gruppe Jaukadakka Afromed.
Dis les noms, s'il te plaît.
Aaron Seitz am Klavier.
Clavier.
Sven Krug am Kontrabass. Ralf Wagner am Schlagzeug. Pierre Ballis.
Pierre Ballis.
Am Altsaxophon.
Eric Petzoldt. Hello, the father of this program, all 10 years.
Jauk, merci. Dankeschön.
Come to theater, 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 theater. No, no, no. We are not a jazz man. Voilà. Thank you.
Dankeschön.
No corona, no corona!